Hello dear students, in this video we are going to study how to calculate equivalent masses of various substances. Okay, so here I will be teaching you the formula to calculate equivalent mass of different type of substances like element, salt, like acid, base, reducing agent, oxidizing agent and all. So let us start with the first kind of substance, that is we are going to study equivalent weight of an element. So there is a formula to calculate equivalent weight of an element, and this formula right now I am going to discuss for such elements which do not show variable valency or which do not exhibit variable valency. So equivalent weight of an element is equals to atomic mass of element divided by its valency. So let us see some examples. Here example, I am taking of oxygen. Suppose we want to calculate equivalent weight of oxygen, so that will be equals to atomic mass of oxygen, that is 16, and valency of oxygen, that is 2, so it will be equals to 8. So 8 is the equivalent mass of oxygen. Same way, let us see the next example, like equivalent mass of magnesium. So equivalent weight of magnesium is equals to its atomic mass is 24 and its valency is also 2, so equivalent mass of magnesium will be 12. I hope it is clear. Now, in case of those elements which exhibit variable valency like copper, case of copper, alright, copper is a kind of substance which exhibits variable valency. We know copper exists in two forms, is found to exist in two forms in different compounds like cuprous, Cu plus and Cu2 plus. So copper will have variable equivalent weight as well. If it has got variable valency, so it will have variable equivalent weight. So as Cu plus cuprous ion, its equivalent weight will be equals to its atomic mass divided by its valency. So its atomic mass is 63.5 upon its valency is 1 right now, so that is equals to 63.5. Alright, now if we want to calculate its equivalent mass as Cu2 plus, so as Cu2 plus, its equivalent mass will be equals to 63.5 upon 2. Alright, so that will be equals to 31.75. That can be written equals to 31.8. I hope it is clear to all of you how to calculate the equivalent weight of an element. Alright, now we are going to see how to calculate equivalent weight of a normal salt. Equivalent weight of a normal salt will have the formula equals to formula weight of the salt divided by total charge on cationic part. Formula weight, I hope you understand the meaning of formula weight, means according to the molecular formula, weight of the salt is known as its formula weight. So I will take example of NaCl. Suppose we want to calculate equivalent weight of NaCl. So its equivalent weight will be equals to its formula weight. Alright. So sodium 23 plus chlorine 35.5. So that is equals to 58.5. So formula weight is 58.5 upon total charge on cationic part. So cation is sodium and the total charge is 1. So divided by 1, that is equals to 58.5 is the equivalent weight of sodium chloride. Now suppose we take example of Na2CO3. Now we want to calculate its equivalent weight. So its equivalent weight will be equals to formula weight of the salt divided by total charge on the cationic part. So its formula weight will be 23 multiplied by 2 plus 12 plus 16 into 3, so 46 plus 12 plus 48, so it will be equals to 8 into 10, 16, 106. So equivalent weight will be equals to 106 upon total charge on the cationic part, so that is Na plus is 2 in number, that means total charge on the cationic part is 2. So 106 will be divided by 2, so equivalent weight will be equals to 53. I hope you have understood how to calculate equivalent weight of a normal salt. Now next is equivalent weight of an acid. So equivalent weight of an acid is equals to molecular weight of acid upon its basicity. For example, if I take example of H2SO4, we want to calculate equivalent weight of H2SO4. Alright, so that will be equal to its molecular mass. So its molecular mass is 98, 1 into 2 plus 32 plus 16 into 4. So 2 plus 32 plus 64. So it is 98. So here we can write 98 upon its basicity. What is basicity of an acid? We all know that it is the number of replaceable hydrogen. So number of replaceable hydrogen are 2. So 98 is divided by 2, that is equals to 49. I hope it is clear. Now similarly, if you know the basicity of all the acids, then you can comfortably calculate their equivalent mass. So equivalent mass of an acid, very very important that you should have the correct idea of the basicity of acid. Why I am saying this? To understand that, just see here. When I say H3PO4, its basicity is 3. But when I say H3PO3, its basicity is not 3. Its basicity is 2. Alright. So you should have the correct knowledge of the basicity of acid. Then only you can calculate the equivalent weight of an acid properly. I hope it is clear. Now next is equivalent weight of base. Equivalent weight of a base is equals to molecular weight of base upon acidity of the base. So here I will take example of calcium hydroxide. Suppose we want to calculate the equivalent mass of calcium hydroxide. So it will be equals to molecular weight of the base. So let us calculate the molecular weight of calcium hydroxide. So 40 plus 2 into 16 plus 1. So 40 plus 2 into 17. So total will be equals to 74. So it will be equals to 74 upon its acidity. What is acidity of a base? It is number of replaceable hydroxide ions. So they are 2 in number. So its equivalent mass will be equals to 37. It's very easy.